Reinforcement available.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, CaptainShack here, and welcome back to, let me pause this, the great campaign in Thrawns Revenge. I'm a little under the weather, so my voice is a little off. It's not your audio equipment. That's actually how I sound. So let's see what's going on. Hey, ho, we've got a new side here. Empire of the Hand, possibly? I don't know. So where's our fleet? Where do we leave off? Well, we somehow had our fleet over Thyfera destroyed, or I accidentally moved them out of the way. We've got a Star Destroyer fleet sitting over Grado. So we're going to have to bring some ships over and actually eliminate whatever's in orbit here. They even have a space station rebuilt. Blah. We did manage to take the Quat shipyards with one of our primary fleets, and our ground troops have managed to capture it, so we should probably defend it. I'm thinking ion cannons. We already have the ion cannon. Shield generator is already up, and as soon as we get the resources, maybe another turbo laser tower? We need to move these ground troops off and get ready for the next invasion. We are going to punch through to Wedge Antilles. He happens to have command of a super star destroyer, and we want that in one of the fleets. So what should we do? Well, what I'm thinking is we'll take the fleet over Corellia. We'll knock out whatever is sitting over this planet and leave a ship behind to blockade it, just like Corellia itself. We'll move our ground troops from Quat shipyards down to take Corellia. That way it's just taken care of now. And then maybe we'll make a new ground army, actually. We have a huge pop cap. So, yeah, you know what? That's what we'll do. We'll order up a new ground force. We have been building troops this entire time. Let's see. Who else should we order up? Well, we're going to need just general infantry as well. We'll build up a second attack force, and that's what we use to invade Corellia. We'll move these ground forces and the fleet onward to try to break through to Wedge. Now, Wedge might be able... He doesn't have much of a supporting fleet. Do you even have... We have a Jedi Knight. Iblis. He's got a Dreadnought-class heavy cruiser. We've got Leia Organa solo. I don't know what she is commanding, but she reduces prices wherever she's at. So she's really in the wrong position. And then Wedge with the Super Star Destroyers. That might be enough to break through the lines at this planet here. I don't know. Well, we could order up ships too, though. I mean, we do have one of the larger ship production facilities right here. We might want to do that. All right, so let's leave a ship behind at Corellia. We'll leave one of you blockade runners. We'll move the rest of the fleet onward, and we'll take out, what are we going to call this? The Eastern Pass, I guess? This is how we're going to reinforce our forces on the western side. So I guess it's the Western Pass. Begin invasion. They actually have some ships here. We're going to have to be careful. Located in the Galactic Core, Falgio is part of the least populated section of Corellian sector. Indeed. Yeah, Corellia's got the extra moons. They've got the moon of Talus, which I didn't see on here. It was one of the bases that my favorite RP group in Star Wars Galaxies actually uses their base of operations. Launch all fighters, prepare for combat.
Star Destroyer standing by.
Here's my Star Destroyer. This is why I'll be captaining the fleet. Captaining? I guess it would be admiraling the fleet. Commanding the fleet. Grab all units, prepare for combat.
Enemy forces ahead.
We're moving out. Hold our formation. Let's see what they've got for defenses. So they've actually got, maybe we've never taken this planet before. They've got two golden platforms. They've got the actual star base that's going to be producing free units. And then they've got a super star destroyer and a decent sized support fleet. Now this is normally where I have the advantage, but they've got quite a few of these Carrick cruisers. Asteroid fields helping defend the star base from all around. Let's go ahead, select all again. Somebody was asking me what the controls are. How am I doing all this? Control A, select all. C, I always go through this in every one of these campaigns. C, and have your mouse over somebody to kind of focus on them. And then, of course, good old space bar to get the cinematic views. That is pretty damn random. All right, we actually have even more units that have just spawned. Let's just keep moving forward. We're moving to about middle of the map. Let's go ahead and start breaking off our group. So control one, getting a group of X-Wings. We're gonna have these guys swing over here. and deal with the incoming enemy bomber squadron. This is a bit overkill. You don't really need the entire fleet. Stop flying through our ships of X-Wings. Oh, you're so dead. You're so dead. That's a lot of dead TIE bombers. All right, so the tankiest ship that we have in the fleet right now would probably be the Star Destroyer and the Admiral, Admiral Akbar, in the new version of Home 1. So what we're gonna do is we should be stopping soon. Bring the X-Wings back up here. We're gonna move these guys in first. This cruiser is just weird.
Yes, Commander.
Now, I got a couple comments, just a couple, about, I mentioned that in the new lore, where is it? The B-Wings have a new actual story. They were in Rebels.
Awaiting orders.
Like how they came to be, and it's actually a really good story. It was a fairly awaiting interesting episode, like most of them on Rebels. There's only been a couple really like, that kind of sucked episodes. All right, let's move you up. You should be just about in range. You're gonna start taking damage. Now that you're taking the damage, let's move in the dreadnoughts and actually start doing the damage. Stop. Start coming about. Come on. Because you're not actually as tanky as I wish you were. All right. Let's commence the attack. All dreadnoughts should be firing. I want you, where's the ability? Where's Akbar? Akbar, I want you to focus all firepower. Oh, you can't do it.
Ready for orders. Reporting in. Ready for command.
Beginning our attack run. All squadrons, target those forward weapons. Nice, but we gotta pull you out now. Pull them out, pull them out. The reason we have to pull them out is because they brought the carrot cruisers up. We do not want to lose all of our fighters this early. All right, let's bring up the rest of the support fleet.
Frigate reporting.
In case they do decide to commit their fighters. Dreadnoughts. Interceptors, get it done. Dreadnought, get out of there. Use those engines. Hold your position here. Bombers, get ready to move in. Good, we're managing to take them out. We're looking pretty good. How are we doing on our tanks? This is the perfect opportunity to take out their support fleet. They're divided. Get out of there. The ISD is moving up. Yes. All right, here we go. We're gonna need our bombers now. All bombers, all fighters. Engage. Engage. Interceptors, continue to take out their fighters. How are you doing? All right, you're holding out. You're holding out. You're holding out. Let's get the X-Wings in there. Begin your attack runs. So we're using the interceptors to clear out the enemy interceptors and fighters because they can actually dodge the larger rounds. The X-Wings are a little iffy on that. Oops. Go ahead and bring in the X-Wings. Have we managed to take the shields out on that? No, we have not, but we are about to take the shield generator out. Beautiful. All right, let's move up the entire fleet. All right, brilliant ship. Move back. ISD move up. On one, move in first. All right, fighters, get in there.
Setting up my runs.
Your orders?
I should be there any moment now.
Ready for command, sir.
Let's take out that Golan platform. Okay, you get out of range, and let's bring in the actual guns. All dreadnoughts. Open fire. We can order up our bombers to move in. Dreadnoughts, you should be firing already. Let's actually move the ISD up to engage the other ISD. It's already got its shields taken down. All right, there's a carrot cruiser. What I would like is for the support fleet. Where is it? Where's that support cruiser? Is it already dead? No, it's just flying through the Golan platform. Watch us melt this thing. So it's taking out our fighters right now, but we are taking out it quick. Look at how many weapons it has. They are just deadly. All right, finish it up. All right, now's our chance. Engage, engage, engage.
Good and gone. Squadron standing.
TIE interceptors. See if we can zoom in on them. Intercept these enemy bombers that are coming in range.
Yes, sir. Laser, linked and ready. Proceed. Fire at will.
We're moving in. Excellent. All right, so the battle's going pretty well. I've recently been talking to a mod author that I've spotlighted this mod before. It's a Star Wars mod for Free Worlds, or for Free Worlds, for Freelancer, an old space game. ISD open fire. I like that it has my colors. Nicely done. Let's tractor beam this. Now, I guess they're redesigning the mod? So I haven't jumped in and played it yet, but Freelancer was this big, like, kind of open sandboxy world where you could do all kinds of cool stuff. It was one of the... It was actually Chris Roberts' last sci-fi game, like his last big sandbox space game. And it was pretty great. It was pretty great. Now, these guys have, like, reworked the entire back end of the code for the game. They've made a whole bunch of Star Wars ships. They've redone the whole universe into the Star Wars universe. And now they're remaking it to where you're not going to need... It's not going to require players to have content, because before, the idea was that players would actually command the different factions. One player would take command of the Empire, and there'd be a whole bunch of players under his command. They'd be building capital ships and stuff, and you'd be fighting over and destroying these capital ships permanently. And what they found was that people wouldn't actually risk using the capital ships. Victory to us. They wouldn't actually, like, go out there with the Super Star Destroyers, right? Or the ISDs, or the ISD2s, or the Victory Classes, and risk them. So now they're making it more... they're putting them on a timer, I guess. They rebalanced all of them in a recent patch. So I'm looking forward to trying it out. The problem is, and I'm curious if you guys know anything about this. This was a great victory for us. Look at those kills. Where can you find a copy of Freelancer? You can't buy it digitally. Without, you know, going to, like, Pirate Bay or something. It's something I really don't want to do. Let's move in and take out the ISD. And then we need to hit Fethera. And then it looks like we have opened up the Western Pass. I'm going to auto-resolve that. Looks like they're retreating. That is fine. Let's go ahead and dig in this sector. All right, that shouldn't take too long. Let's go ahead and take out the fleet that's over this. I want to make sure this whole pass is secure.
Tactical battle imminent.
It's just a space station. Let's auto-resolve it. Space station and two golem platforms destroyed. Excellent. Now we're going to have to leave another ship here. This is kind of draining our ships. We're going to have to do something about this. Let's move you up as a defense fleet. You're going to be the Western defense fleet now. We have to start refreshing our combat vessels. Capital shipyard.
Construction.
We'll put that on the queue to build. How goes the training of the ground troops?
Tactical battle imminent.
What's up? What do we have? Oh, they brought ships over calm. Well, that was just silly. It's a single Lancer frigate, so we'll just destroy that. And we'll destroy that. Oh, we lost a dreadnought over that. See, that's... Auto-resolve, not always the best thing. If we take Biss, that could save us a lot of trouble.
Constructing.
How's the fleet doing, though? I feel like we want to refresh that. We want to build the force up a bit before we move in. We have had some casualties. There's not a lot of a support fleet left. There's only four dreadnoughts remaining outside of the advanced dreadnought. I think we can wait. We can wait a little bit, but let's go ahead and start building up the ground troops over Duros. What I'm going to do is...
Tactical battle.
What do we got? They're going after our starbase? You want to go? Let's do this. Because... Oh, it's not done yet. Shit.
Building. Cancel.
Cancel it. Get all the money back. Auto-resolve it. Bring the fleet in. We need to attack this planet.
Tactical battle imminent.
We lost a dreadnought. Damn it. Bring the Draenor up from Foundor. Do we have any reinforcements back here? Ships that we could pull in? Doesn't look like we do. We've got one Nebulon B, actually, we could bring up. So let's go ahead and bring you up. Reinforce the fleet. Do you have an ion cannon? No, you don't, but you need one. Get that in your life.
Construction complete.
Get a star base, and let's get you some cheap combat vessels ready to go.
Constructing unit.
As cheap as capital ships go, and they're kind of tanky. I'm bringing them over. That way they can sit there and take the take the fire while the ion cannon knocks them out. We could divide the fleet up, because I don't want to hit this yet. It's a level 2 space station. Lord knows what kind of ships they've got in orbit. They keep hitting us. But once we do take it, it'll be a single point of defense instead of two, which I really like the complete. Idea of. Other areas of business that need to be, excuse me, handled. We need to deploy more mines. You guys have talked about this many times, says Shaq.
Beginning
you should have a mine in every open space that
building
you can get
under construction.
To be able to replace lost troops. This doesn't increase
tactical
income, does it? I don't think
imminent.
So. Yeah, they're really focused on this. Did we get our ion cannon operational? We did not. All right, we are going to sit. Auto-resolve it. We're losing another space station. We are going to sit on this planet until that ion cannon. Is it finished? It is finished. We have an ion cannon here now. Good. Let's divide the fleet up. My command ISD and a couple of Nebulon Bees.
Construction complete.
Actually, let's just leave one there. And give me a dreadnought. Complete. We will defend this planet while we move the rest of the fleet over. We will take
complete.
Direct command.
Imminent.
Let's order up a space station here. Direct command of this fleet. We don't want to risk losing another effing ship to auto-resolve. Take out this super Star Destroyer. This normal Star Destroyer. Probably just a Imperial II. And that should be enough defenses. Once the ion cannon comes online. We've got to rebuild the fleet. When this week ends, we'll have more income we can really invest. Probably going to invest in more Mon Cal ships and dreadnoughts. Because to be honest, I mean, it's cool. The Majestic here is kind of cool, but that's not a rebel ship to me. This is a rebel
reporting
ship to
in.
Me. Mon Calamari ships.
We've located the enemy.
We've located the enemy. Make sure they can't get away. Drop the gravity well. They're coming right for us.
Awaiting orders.
I only have one Y-wing.
Ready. Right away. Moving out.
Let's move out.
Ready for battle.
B-wing here.
B-wing here. We have the lucky lady here as well, or Lady Luck. So I got that support fleet, it's coming in. Now this thing, this modular task force cruiser, I don't see that all that useful. Like it has the, oh, it has the droids, yeah. It has droid fighters, which is weird, interesting, but its shields can't hold out to much and we just detonated it. And look, its weapons are spread all over the place. Is this supposed to be their version of the Quasar? Come on in. Come out of the asteroid field and attack this target. Beginning our attack run. They'll never expect us to come out of the asteroid field. So the asteroid fields don't really, they're not really a tactical advantage and you can't really use them to your advantage in any fun ways. In this. All right, beginning our attack run. Photons away. Protons, not photons. X-Wings, engage those fighters. Oh, he's such a dead man. Just watch this in cinematic mode. This battle's already over. They've got hull breaches on all decks.
The enemy has been defeated.
Sweet. Once the ion cannon comes online, that'll make this system pretty easy to hold, as well as a starbase.
Construction complete.
And we've got the secondary fleet back
fleet
here.
Approaching.
Okay, we're gonna pause this because I really want to start gathering up the ground troops. They're about to invade one of our planets. We want to break through. I kind of want to use him in a battle. I guess I could always retreat if worst came to worst. Collect this entire fleet up and just roll out. Who are you? Oh, a Jedi Knight. However, he lacks the ability to use telekinesis. Yeah, it's extended universe, old extended universe stuff, so I don't actually know what half these characters are. Let's focus on Duro. Let's see if we can get some more
tactical
ships.
Battle imminent.
What are you attacking? All right, that seems just silly. There's a fleet twice your size there. Three times your size. Auto-resolve that battle. Great victory to us. I will say this, compared to Republic at War, auto-resolve seems to work pretty well. It's a hell of a lot better than Republic at War's auto-resolve. Something to do with how they weigh out, I guess, the units individually.
Enemy
good
fleet
grief.
Approaching.
I think they're about to hit us again, maybe with the actual ships that they had planned to... No, just one single... Really? That's all you've got. Auto-resolve that. Vindicator heavy cruiser.
Right away, sir.
What do we got for ground troops? All right, infantry and support units. Let's move out.
Enemy fleet approaching. Construction
That's
complete.
A new place.
Tactical battle imminent.
Ho! Oh, shit. Okay, that's a fleet. Where are you hitting? Oh, shit. Okay, so that's the Empire of the Hand fleet. This is the first time I think I've fought the Empire of the Hand. I've been fighting the Remnant this whole time. That's... They've actually built a few fighter squadrons and support ships. I don't have much here. We have to break through and get them reinforcements. They're going to wreck us. Let's begin the battle because I want to see this fleet. A beautiful plain-covered world and the colonies. Naquazar was used by the New Republic in the lead-up on the assault on Coruscant. Well, it's not within our control anymore. We're about to lose it, at least lose the orbit of it. I don't know what kind of ground troops we've got to defend it, but what in the world are you? All ships, report back to the Golan platform. That's where we'll make our stand. Come about. We're picking up some large craft out there. Can't see what it is, though.
Copy. There they are.
Fighter squadrons, Golan
Responding.
Platform. Let's do
Proceeding
this.
Proceeding to coordinates.
Enemy fighters. Okay, we got a victory class in there that I do recognize, but these are monsters. Ascendancy Star Destroyers? Let me see if I can pause this. I want to read it. Ascendancy Star Destroyer, developed in cooperation with the Chiss Ascendancy. Based on Imperial designs, the Ascendancy served with the Saikan Fleet Systems Syndicate Destroyer as the main capital ship of the Empire of the Hand. Designed to be slightly more versatile than the Syndic, the Ascendancy trades some of its direct ship-to-ship combat abilities for the larger destroyers for more versatility. Okay, so she's not as, like, she doesn't have as many weapons. Quad heavy mega maser. What? Heavy ion cannons? They're gonna be able to wreck shields. This could be a problem. All right, let's break the fighters off and engage these enemy TIEs that are coming in. See what kind of damage we can do. We don't want to get caught by the rest of the fleet. Come on, boys. All right, pull off. Get into cruise mode and run. Look at all those fighters. Man, they've got a lot of fighters. This is going to be a problem. Get in there, boys. Except for you bombers. I don't know why you Y-Wings have decided that dogfighting is what you want to get into today. All right, lock wings. In attack position. Let's get ready. We want the Golan platform to take the bulk of the damage. So get behind it. Use it as a shield. X-Wings, only engage those fighters that make their way around. How good are you guys one-on-one? I want to see who wins this battle. Get in there. All right, let's cause some casualties. Take them down. All right, the station's under attack. That's our moment. Okay, those are bombers coming in. Now I know what bombers look like for this fight. Shit, that just cost us half our shields. All right, all units, focus fire. All right, they've got a sizable support fleet. Let's focus on taking that out while we take out these bombers. Support ships are our primary target. Shields are already down on the Golan platform. We're gonna lose this. I'm ordering the retreat. We might be able to save a couple of these ships, maybe a Nebulon, being a couple of dreadnoughts. Get out of here, boys. Get out of here. Oh no, his engines are down. We're gonna lose him. A few ships survived. I think we had a Nebulon and a dreadnought get out of there. I'm hoping that they rendezvous with the Super Star Destroyer. We might be able to hold that without issue. Damn, we lost both Nebulons. I really wanted to keep those fighters alive. How are you doing for an ion cannon? Psh, we're building you one now. They are hitting us all over the place. All right, that's just another shitty attack. What are you doing? Enemy losses are absolute there on the eastern side. All right, we're going to prep this ground invasion of Corellia, and then we will focus on punching through. See, I kind of want to just gather up all the remaining rebels and just move them out and make the shipyards our main defensive platform. We need to secure these back planets. So, we were moving, what, infantry? We've already moved the infantry up. We've moved our armor up. How big is the force that we've got, the attack force? Four groups of heavy armor, a transport, and we could use more infantry, actually. Yeah, let's get some just more infantry. Wait, you're Republic commandos. We don't want you. We want platoons.
Enlisting soldiers.
Get it done. Denon can do the same thing.
Recruiting soldiers. Vehicle in production.
We need just general ground troops. You got anything on the ground? No, you don't. All right, let's resume this. Get those reinforcements. We do have ground troops. One fleet over. It's not very far. Oh, are they actually hitting us with a proper fleet now? Why didn't they bulk attack with these guys? The fleet has gotten larger. We're ordering up an ion cannon. Two ISDs, three squadrons of fighters. This could be a problem. And I don't think I've built any defensive stations.
Constructing.
All right, we need to hold this until these stations are online. We must hold the line. Pindar. Tropical outer... Oh, yeah, we've fought over this planet before. Or we've taken this from them. I think this was one of the first eastern side planets that we actually conquered. Maybe not. Launch all fighters, prepare for combat. We've got one of our old MC-80s, the Alliance, here, leading this fleet. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab all fighters, we're gonna move in and engage them. We're not gonna wait. The Alliance will be taking point. Alright, X-Wings. All units, move up. We're not messing around, we're going in. Take them out. What do we have in the backpack here? Looks like two squadrons of Y-Wings and two X-Wing squadrons. That's fine. All right. They're getting a little too close for comfort. Let's get the MC-80 up there. The one ship that should never be taking point is a Quasar. Support fleet, fall back. All right, bombers are already in there. Let's get the rest of the Y-Wings going in after their shield generators. Let's take them down. All right, now that the fleet has turned around and the MC-80 is the closest ship, we're moving in. Everything we've got, let's go. Take them down. The rest of the Y-Wings back from the Starbase are coming in. Good. Stay in the north. How are you doing over here? Your shields are holding. Don't get too close to that Super Star Destroyer's combat. Or weapons. You don't get within weapon range. We want this thing focusing on the Corellian ships. We kept them to the north. All right, one Superstar Destroyer down. All ships, open fire. Grab a Y-Wing. Oh, nope, I want to see the Y-Wing make its attack run. Ah. I just love the scale in this game. It's so good. And you don't really get that scale unless you can zoom in and actually see it from the perspective of a fighter pilot. If they ever did a remake of this, and they wanted to try having a cinematic mode, but having it... like a new way of doing it to really give you a sense of scale. Have some new camera, like when I hit spacebar, it'll go through all these camera views. Have one of the camera views be from inside the cockpit of an X-Wing or a Y-Wing, right? Like when it cycles through them all. Have one of them be from the bridge of a Super Star Destroyer. Just imagine how cool that would look. All right, so we've taken out the enemy fleet that attacked us. We are building an ion cannon. We are building two Golem platforms over here to defend this. Yavin, how is Yavin doing ground defense-wise? I think we already built an ion cannon over here. And I believe we are ready. We've got another cutoff planet out there. It's amazing that Ithor and Levian haven't been attacked. All right, we're ready to move in the ground troops. Is there anything from the main army that I want to bring in? I'd like to bring in some light tanks, actually. So let's bring you guys south.
T2B over.
And let's start ordering up some ships.
Constructing unit. Construction complete.
Reporting.
Unit in production.
We need to get some dreadnoughts as well, but we're full up right now on construction, so that's fine. We're ready to begin the invasion. Oh, no, we're not. Where's our ground? Where's our
enemy
infantry?
Fleet approaching.
Reporting.
Nope, begin the battle. We're never going to invade Corellia if we don't do it right now, because they're going to keep attacking us in the north.
Invasion
we can't have
commencing.
That. Who in the hell are you? Begin the battle. It's not much on the ground. At least in an actual holding army. Notice that every single one of the slots on this planet are full, so they could easily be just producing units. Corellia is a temperate planet covered by rolling hills, thick forests, the homeworld of Han Solo.
The enemy has been spotted. Yes.
So we actually control the center, and we control... There's a turbo laser tower right here. Get over there and secure that turbo laser tower. Stormtroopers coming in from the north. Come on, capture that. Sweet babies, what is happening?
We've secured
here,
a build pad.
So they gave us a couple of, like, bases, and then we immediately lost them. This is like a weird snow-covered planet.
At your service.
Capture this.
Moving out.
We need to bring them reinforcements. It looks like they're about to capture this. It still says abandoned.
All right,
let's bring in some air support to help everybody out. Let's bring in some heavy tanks.
Right away, sir.
And maybe another group of rocket infantry. Hold out for a little bit longer. We'll have support there if they haven't already captured that damn super tower. Oh, they have. Shit. All right. Nope, we're not going in. We're not going in. Can you boys make it to the north?
Commander,
and you guys, ready, let's make a group one so we can get some actual eyes on. It looks like they're losing it. Or do they still control it? I don't know, I can't see
moving
it.
To coordinates.
Don't want
to
lose an
Roger
aircraft.
That.
Nope,
right
they still away. Control it. Get out of there. We've actually got enemy ground troops pushing up.
Almost there.
I don't think
right
so. All right, hold this position. Heavy tanks coming behind them and rocket infantry. We may have to just sit here and hold this out. Give them air support.
Can I assist you?
We've secured a build pad.
Anti-infantry.
When do you need me? Right away. Roger that. Ground target locked.
Get in your attack. Can they fire back? They can fire back. If we can capture this, we can bring in more reinforcements. I really would have liked to have captured this, but it just wasn't gonna happen unless you're really fast on it.
Construction complete.
Yeah, keep hitting them. Oh, we have to move up infantry.
Waiting instructions.
All right, one armor, two infantry groups. Make you group two. Attack move, get up here. Push through so we can call in reinforcements. I'm doing everything I can to help you. And reinforcements are on the way. Where are they running to? No. You can't head north? Yeah, you could head north. This is a really weird planet. You'd be able to just walk up here. Are they on the move?
Unit
they're on the move.
Destroyed.
We secured a build pad.
Unit destroyed.
Damn it. They brought in anti-air and we just lost that air unit. Shit. We've got to push up here with ground troops. But we can't lose this. And there's no defensive turrets down here. And that's a Lambda shuttle on fire. Which kind of cracks me up. Get some more defenses. All right.
Almost there.
We'll group up. At the edge here. We can bring in more reinforcements. Debating what's the proper thing to bring in. T2Bs. They can get up there faster than anything else. Alright, hold position. Come on, armor. Oh, sweet babies, that's a lot. They're not gonna win that battle. Get out of there. There's those T2Bs. Get up here.
On it, sir.
Those rocket infantry need to get out of the way. We can fall back to the defenses.
Hello, Commander.
You can get back to the defenses, we'll be good. T2Bs are almost
T2B,
in range.
Copy.
You ready to turn around? All right, give them the good news.
I copy. I've got him in my sight.
We have rocket infantry, that's what I'm relying on. Where in the world are you going? Fall back.
Armor ready. And it's charged.
Use those shields. All right, fall back, let the shields recharge. Target the tanks.
Right behind you. Ready to roll.
And remember, they're getting these units for free. I can't replace mine. Come on, take out those shields. Come on, infantry. Take them down. Rockets away. Shit. Did we lose all those T2Bs? We did. Damn it. Fall back. Fall back to the turrets. Alright, give him a rocket. You've got one rocket infantry left. Friggin' Bob here. Bob is on this. Bob really is on this. Come on, Bob.
Fallout troops.
Alright, we're gonna have to hold here. Wait for
Roger that.
The base to be rebuilt. Okay, we need to pick the proper unit for this. Artillery support followed by heavy armor.
Maximum unit capacity.
They have not attacked us from this side in quite some time. Why don't we have the ability to orbital blast this place? I just realized that's a thing. We're falling back.
We can't hold out any longer.
We can hold out, we're just not going to. We don't have, I guess, the proper ship in orbit to give us any type of support. We need to bring one of like the MC-80s over here, bombers or something. All right, pause it real quick. Yeah, we have no ships in orbit, that's why. That's why. Let's pull back.
Construction complete.
The support ship for the MC-80. What? Yavin 4 is under attack, auto-resolve that. I really want to do this ground battle. And let's move some more ground troops and move these units out. What? Yavin 4 is under attack. I gotcha. Auto-resolve it. You have won the Battle of Yavin 4. Excellent. Couldn't be prouder.
Enemy fleet approaching.
Reinforcements en route. Quickly. Engage. Auto-resolve it. You've won the Battle of Yavin 4. We did lose a Marauder cruiser, though. Yeah, they're like trickling units up there. Now, the Empire of the Hand doesn't seem to be doing that. They're actually punching me straight in the face. But the Imperial Revenant, on the other hand... Alright, we should have orbital support this time. That's why we fell back. If we've got an MC-80, it's got bombers in its bays. We now have orbital strikes. Excellent. Alright, what is going on up here? They're like... purging the planet. Alright, all units, move over here. What do we got on the ground right now? Let's drop something fast. Air units can get over there pretty quickly, and I guess the T-1Bs will have to work. Infantry move out. Let's see if we can capture this.
We've secured a build pad.
Anti-infantry turrets construct now.
We've captured an abandoned turbo laser tower.
Yes, the turbo laser tower is ours this time. Come on, capture it. We want anti-infantry. We want to bring in our air units to back them up. Because it was almost instantaneous that they got troops down here.
Alright,
you guys scout for us.
Awaiting orders.
You guys, capture that point. Let's go armor to hold this position.
Copy. Advance.
Move the armor in. What's going on up here? Civilians are under attack. See if we can move these civilians to the north. Oh, they're starting to come in. They were a little slower this time. Let them come within range of the turrets.
Alright.
Hold up over here. We've got incoming stormtroopers. See, I built the anti-tank one over here. Thinking it would be the right choice. Probably not. We need anti-infantry. Rocket tanks. We can roll them up north. How you guys doing? We can actually move our ground troops north and capture this. If we capture this, fall back. Fall back. Get out of range of that. Okay. If we can capture this, we can call in reinforcements. I'd like to bring in some armor. Some artillery support would be great.
We've secured a build pad.
Two turbo laser towers up there? That's why they died.
Roger that.
All right, let's get those anti-armor defenses online. This is an anti-infantry, anti-aircraft support vehicle. We don't want to be using that against those heavy armor that they've got. Let's go ahead and get that artillery in position.
Yes, Commander. Can I help?
Heading out, sir. Providing
backup. Here they come. These things are fantastic. Don't come in here. Get out. Executing flyby. Our air units just keep moving in. Actually, head over here and harass. See what they've got.
Construction complete. Turret constructing.
Doesn't look like they want to move their units any closer. Their armor. Let's spread it out just a little bit. They keep bringing in stormtroopers to poke at our defenses, but that's it.
Engines primed. Reporting.
I'm not sure if we're going to be in range with the artillery.
Ready.
But let's deploy it anyways. Take a look.
Awaiting orders.
Civilians, I need some intel from inside the enemy base. We captured this? We didn't even use it.
All right. Okay.
And let's get a support unit down to start repairing. There's a specialist.
Moving out.
Moving out. Why do you land in a Lambda in one of the Imperial Assault Shuttles? It's weird. That's pretty strange. All right, and give us another platoon of infantry. So, civilians are here.
I copy.
Hold. I don't know why you're moving. Hold position. I want to see if you're going to be in range.
Over there.
If not, we'll just use an orbital blast of the turbo laser towers. No?
Yes,
like, look at their production facility. This is perfect for an orbital strike if we can just see it. I hate to say it, but I might just fly in a group of
maximum unit capacity
of air units of assault craft.
Sir?
See if you can make it to that capture point.
I'm here.
Oh, 2 seconds after leaving the area. Rockets. Take them down. Now we'll be able to make it there. Come on, take them down. All right, we're moving out. New Republic troops have entered the base. We just have to take this point. We capture, we can bring in reinforcements. I'm thinking some more heavy armor.
Available.
All right, yep. They built another anti-aircraft turret over here.
Ready to help.
We've almost captured it. This should increase our build cap, right? This is one of those kind of points. It is. Okay, let's bring in some heavy armor. Let's bring in some more air units.
Reporting in. Standing by.
We've secured.
Ready to go.
Armor standing by.
Armor standing by.
At maximum unit capacity.
We can dig in here. Civilians, set up some defensive turrets.
We've lost a build pad.
Now, unlike the other maps that I've been to, this one didn't actually reveal itself completely. I wonder if it's because it's, well, it's these walking paths.
A build pad.
These walking paths here. That might be why.
We've secured a build pad.
Okay, let's see here. Let's get some anti-armor. Let's move our anti-infantry tanks up a bit.
Waiting orders.
So they've got a ton of defenses. I really want to know.
Ready, sir.
Whoop! Somebody done screwed up. I really want
to
know where their power is coming from to run all those factories and all those turbo laser towers. Aha!
Complete.
Sit here and hold this. This is now primary objective. We're gonna move two heavy tanks.
Moving out. Copy.
I'm just gonna divide you guys up.
I copy.
Give me two squads.
Let's go. I copy, sir.
This will allow us to see where the enemy is at. Why can't I tell you to move up here? How are we supposed to capture? Oh, it's only infantry.
Reporting.
I bet. Yep, only infantry can make it up here. Well then, get up there. I love these maps. They've actually got some pretty cool mechanics to them. So these little like pathways, they're not wide enough. Switch over. They're not wide enough for armor to get through, so you have to take infantry up here. So this would, if you're playing, say, multiplayer, force an infantry battle of stormtroopers versus, you know, rebel commandos or whatever. Once we get over here, though, we'll be able to capture this. Our air support hovering above and see the entire map. Then we'll be able to call in artillery strikes. Possibly just take out, if we could find it, I'll call it a bombing run, and we'll take out their power supply. If not, We'll do an orbital strike right here on the center of their production facilities and just call it good. Aha! Found you. Got a mercenary outfitter back here. Not really a priority target. They also got a heavy production facility in the back. Well, first objective has to be... This isn't fully charged yet. I can't call it in. Has to be take out the enemy defenses. So, let's call in a group of Y-Wings. You really gonna fly through the enemy base? I can see the AA guns on the left-hand side. They're taking fire. The heavy shields are holding. Gold Squadron, begin bombardment. How many survived? One bomber made it. Was it enough? It wasn't enough. That's all right, though. We've got our assault group. I'm moving them in. What the heck? The mercenaries aren't friendly. They're attacking.
Bombardment.
All right, so our aircraft are moving out. I've ordered them to report here. Here they come. Beginning our attack run. Didn't manage to destroy on the first run. There she goes. All right, their defenses have been powered down. Let's go ahead and take out an ATST because we can. All right, we're starting to take damage. I don't see any defenses back here at this heavy production facility. Can we take this out with just air units? Oh shit. Never mind. Pull our units back. Can we do a bombing? Yes, we can. Strike it. Do it now. Before we lose sensor contact. Boom. And there's an AT-AT down here. Beautiful. We just took out so many units. All right, how we doing? We just lost that infantry. The entire infantry unit to the north is down. We're gonna have to call in reinforcements.
Where should I go?
Let's call in civilian reinforcements. They can take care of it. Get up there. Just don't go through the center.
Waiting orders. Copy.
Group two.
Keep going.
Help defend that this time. I mean, they're sure as hell not gonna break through the center.
Can I do something? Yes, sir. Do you want any help?
Yes, right I do. Away.
Ready?
You civilians have your orders. Move
on
up. We're gonna plan our invasion. Ground troops are going to move in from both the south and the east. And we're going to take this base out. First, I want eyes on again, so we need to take this abandoned sensor array. Now, I took out their power. That means they lost their turbo laser towers. What they did not lose, though, were their anti-aircraft batteries. Those still should be functional.
Right, sir.
All right, capture the sensor array. Shouldn't take too long. Make sure you're close enough to the thing.
We've secured an abandoned sensor.
All right, we got it. Looks like we didn't manage to take out all of the factories. Nope, those are just the turbo laser towers, which are powered down anyways. They do still have a sizable force defending this. So we're gonna have to do this in sync. First things first.
Armor ready.
Infantry and armor form
ready
up.
To roll.
I have...
I copy.
Oh, you're just normal infantry. You're not
yes,
even
sir.
Rocket infantry. Shit.
Roger that.
All right, let's move you boys up.
We've got
it's
your gonna, back.
It's gonna be tight.
Roger that.
Fold it up.
Form up.
All right, focus your fire on the ATST. The artillery is coming up now. Come on, take it down. You know, I forgot how strong those things are.
Destroyed.
Ouch. Oh, are they gonna make a push? Make a push, you know you want to.
Copy. Reporting, right away.
If we had rocket infantry down there, we could have done it. Let's bring in the heavy
right
armor.
Away, sir.
He's got a sniper rifle and he can plant explosives. Which is cool, it doesn't do us any good in this instance. Another walker. Well, we've almost got another. Damn, look at the armor they've got.
I copy.
We have a heavy armor division here. Let's bring you in first. Bring in two heavy armor groups. And a rocket to support.
Yes,
and we'll just sit at the edge.
Let's go.
see what they want to do. Might be able to bring in some artillery. Nah. All of our artillery is to the south right now.
Copy.
Yes, Commander.
Take point.
This way.
I copy.
A proper strike with all of my air units
Yes, sir.
Could easily take out that ATST. What is this? Anti-infantry turret. All right, let's do it. Air units inbound. Swing in from the south. All right, fall back.
Over there.
That friendly fire from the artillery. I do not want to be a part of that. Open up.
Yes, Commander. Over there.
Attack wings. Get over here. Begin your attack. Come on. There they go. There they go. Beautiful.
Unit destroyed.
Target's down.
Unit destroyed.
In route. Moving.
Unit destroyed.
Damn it. They've got anti-air.
Bombing,
bombing run is available. We need to take out.
Unit destroyed.
Did you just. Yep. Our air units just flew back into the base, even though I told them to head south. Bombing run is available. They've got two production facilities to the north I would really like to take out.
Roger that.
It's almost out of sight.
Computer's locked on target.
All right, they're coming in.
Gold squadron.
Oh, here we go. Yeah, come on in. We need to make the move. We need to go in.
Ready for action.
Now that we've gotten rid of that AT-AT, we can actually go in and take them out. Yeah, take out these turbo laser towers just to get them off the grid. Here comes our bombers. It's only gonna be able to take out one of these factories. I'll take what I can get. Oh, they just produce. That was just another light tank.
Attack.
Open up, bottom.
Fire.
Should be the last of their heavy tanks in this area.
Moving into position. Right away, sir. Underway.
Got more turrets, though.
Almost there. Open fire.
Come on, take it out. Switch to the turrets. Switch to the ATSTs. Another heavy armor just came in. Come on, take him down. We're about to lose another heavy armor group. The rockets aren't going to be very good against these guys. We need to bring in more heavy armor. We can bring in all of our heavy armor right now.
Give me a target.
Unit destroyed.
What? Fall back. There's a fucking Jedi or a Sith down there. Shit. That was unexpected. Just run away. Run away. Run away and call in a sniper. Maybe the snipers can deal with it. Is it going to chase you? It is going to chase you. Well, have it chase you into a division of armor. Now let's take her down. Him down. Damn Sith in the field. All right, heavy armor.
Right away.
Time to take out the last factory.
Entering battlefield.
Attack move. The order's been given.
Your orders.
Now, how cool is that? This reminds me of our planet side match the other day with the community. Just tons of tanks rolling out. I like that they do kind of break up into two columns. That's pretty neat. Just get out of the way. Destroy everything en route.
Roger that. Waiting.
No, you guys need to stay right where you are. All right, let's move up the rest of the force.
Come on, men. This way.
Engaging target.
I copy. Torpedo launcher mobile, sir. Torpedoes away.
Fall back. Let the artillery deal with it. Artillery away. Good. That'll just take a few seconds to take out. All right, so the armored column is almost to the Imperial Heavy Factory. Once they arrive, we've won this. That's a lot of tanks. We need to build more of these. They don't have the shields, but the heavy armor and then those armor-piercing cannons are just fantastic. Almost in range. All right, take out the factory. Oh, shit! Wow, they took it out. There was an AT-AT. The second they showed up, the thing produced an AT-AT. But we've already won, so it's all good. Oh, man. All right. You know, overall, that's not bad. Loss-wise, we did lose 3 V-Wings. They're so easy to lose, though. But taking out that major production facility, yeah, that was worth it. That's going to have a huge income for us. Or it's going to produce vehicles like mad if we decide to go heavy production just like they did. You know, it's Corellia. It might as well be a production facility. I'm curious what you guys think. Should we turn Corellia into a major, like, armor production facility for the front line? Since we're already building our main fleet, or we will be building our main fleet over at the Quat shipyards. Let me know in the comments below if you're enjoying this. Hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in the next episode, because it looks like we're going to be breaking through these two planets, I think, and getting Wedge into the fight. We need to prepare for the oncoming onslaught of the Empire of the Hand. They're not messing around. All right, guys, later.